In this video, I'm going to share how you can create better video right with inside Canva. Katie Lance here, and if you've been following me for any period of time, you know I love Canva, especially for real estate agents. There's so many great tools available, especially being able to create video content, right? There's nothing like creating content in your voice and your personality, and there are so many awesome tools available right within Canva to make it so much easier. So in this video, I'm gonna share some of my favorite tips, tools, and tricks for how you can use Canva to take your video to the next level, especially if you're in real estate. Now, before we get into the tips, I would love if you'd hit that subscribe button and the bell button as we have new videos like this that come out each and every week. All right, let's get into Canva for video. Okay, so I'm at my computer and I want to dig in and show you some of the cool things that you can do with Canva for video. Like I said, I love using my desktop version of Canva. I know there is a mobile version and the app is great, but for the purpose of this video, we're going to share some of the things that I think are best to be created on the desktop version. Okay, so let's go into Canva and we're going to click create design. And we're gonna just type in the word video, and there's gonna be lots of options that come up. Let's just click this one. This is going to pull up a horizontal video. And this is kind of a blank slate, but on the left-hand side, you can see there are a number of templates, which is great. So if you are literally starting from scratch, if you have not recorded something, there are some really great templates that you can check out. For example, this first one right here, I'll just click on this one. This is a 19-second video. As I click on it, you can see there's 5 different pages to it. I can click apply all pages, and within just a matter of seconds, it's going to create a really quick 19-second video that you can edit. So you can see it says Jasmine Chastain, real estate agent. So we can change this out. I can double click on this. I can take that out. I can change that out with a picture of myself. You can add in obviously your own picture right here. And of course you could upload a picture of yourself, whatever you'd like. I could click upload. Let's find a quick picture on my computer of myself that we can upload. There we go. So if I was creating this, I could upload this really quick. And while that's uploading, I'm just going to change this out. And I could have this be, you know, Katie Lance, real estate agent, or whatever your title is. I'm going to click my picture right here and add this on really kind of quickly and easily. Let's move that around a little bit, kind of resize that just a tad, and bring that in here, bring that in here. And I'm just going to make some simple edits on this template. So I'm not going to do anything major. I'm just going to kind of edit with what's already here. Then I have here, it says 89 properties sold in 2022. So I would edit this, whatever the properties were. Let's say I sold 50. As an example, 50 properties sold in 2022. You could also then change out these graphics. So I can delete all these little photos right here, which is kind of cool. Again, this is just all a simple template, all right within Canva. So then we can just grab some photos. You can upload them if you haven't uploaded them yet, or you can just drag them from your uploaded files. And I'm just gonna drag over a bunch of pictures for the sake of this example. Let's drag over this one, and I'm probably gonna have a couple duplicates just to make this easy for this example. And then the next one says lifelong local resident, right? Which I probably would keep the same. Again, there's a picture of this person who's not me. So let's delete that. Let's put me up there. If I had another picture of myself handy, I probably would put something else right here, maybe me in the community, right? And of course I would change out these pictures to local community pictures. From here, again, I could change this out. I could take that out, add myself again if I wanted, or just leave it blank, or maybe add a picture of, you know, a home or something like that, whatever I'd like. Maybe we add a little picture right here. And then this is where we would put a testimonial. So if you've got some great testimonials on Zillow, Realtor.com, whatever, there you go. You can change that out, of course. And then again, you would change out that last picture to, again, yourself. So I'm feeling like this is a lot of pictures of me. I probably would change it up and have a few different pictures, maybe some client pictures, right? So it's not just all me, but the purpose of this particular video is really to be kind of a video about who you are and what you're all about. And then of course I would change out my website and all that contact info. So within a matter of a couple minutes, I've created something really quickly and easily. I can click play and you can see it's going through and showing you what it looks like.
I can even hit play in the upper right hand corner and it's going to pull it up really quick. And so now without even really being on camera, I've created something quickly and easily that I could upload to YouTube. I could put on my Facebook channel. I could put on LinkedIn. I could put anywhere. And you can see at the bottom, it shows you how long it is. It's about a 23-second video. So that is, again, just one template. And again, to show to as far as how we got to that, we just opened up Canva. We went to a blank video template. And if I close out that here really quick and just bring you back over to where we see templates, you can see there's lots of different templates available. And you can actually search different real estate templates. If I were to go in and search real estate, there's that top one right there. This is actually a free template, I believe, which is great. There's a lot of free templates. There's also paid templates. And you can kind of scroll through. And again, this is a great place, I think, to really start or if you want to enhance your video library. Now, I want to share a couple other quick tips when it comes to video. So let's go back to my home screen and we're going to start another blank slate again. So let's hit the word video right here. And this is going to be great if you want to do some recording directly into Canva. So maybe you want to do some videos where you're sharing helpful tips, helpful information. Maybe you're doing like a tip Tuesday, or you're doing, you know, where you're sharing a real estate tip of the week, or maybe you're doing a Monday market update, or maybe you're doing a featured Friday. So you can go into Canva right here. And on the left-hand side under uploads, you can either upload your video. So if you're recording video on your phone or somewhere else, you can upload it directly into Canva. You can see I've got a bunch of videos uploaded here, or you can click this record button. And this is the really cool part. You can actually record yourself all right within Canva. So there you can see me down there. Now it's going to record in circle, but you can also increase it to full size if you'd like. I can even change the shape if you want yourself to be a little bit of a square size, that is, so to speak. And then you can also turn the camera off if you just wanted to record your voice, which is fine as well. So what's kind of cool about this too is if you want to record, let's say you want to record a market update and maybe you've got something behind you, maybe you want to talk about, you know, the market as an example, maybe you're a local realtor here in the San Francisco Bay Area, you could record a quick video and then have your market report or your picture behind you. So let me just share with you what that looks like. I'm just going to record a couple quick seconds as an example. You're going to see when I hit record, there's going to be a countdown button and we're going to show you how this works. Okay, so we're just recording a quick sample example of what a quick market update video could look like if I was a realtor in the San Francisco Bay Area. Okay, so that was super quick, right? That was like 9 seconds. Obviously yours would be a little bit longer. You could hit play and you could listen to it. You could delete it if you want to record it again, but as I always say, done is better than perfect. And then when you're ready to do a little bit of editing, don't worry, this is easy, I promise. You're going to click save and exit in the upper right-hand corner. And what's going to happen is it's going to bring it right here. I'm going to hit pause. It's going to bring it right into your design. And on the left-hand side, you can see it's uploading as well. So by default, it's going to bring in this little circle right here, which is kind of cool. If I didn't want it to be if I wanted it to be full screen, I could just delete it and bring in that full video and it would be full screen. But we're going to leave it as a circle right now because under images, I already have a San Francisco image that I want to drag to the back of this video. So I can now have myself and I can make myself a little bit larger if I'd like. And I can also add some text. So if I'm doing a little video about the San Francisco market, I could easily go like this. And let's bring that text up here really quick. And maybe we put San Francisco market update, right? So let's do that. Let's make this bigger. And let's put this up on my video like that. Maybe make it to the left like this. And of course, there's other things we could add if we wanted to make it bigger, or we wanted to add some icons. I'm going to keep it pretty simple for the sake of this video. So what you're going to do is record the video first. So even though you won't see what's behind you, I find it's easier to record the video first, keep it really simple. You know, maybe it's a 1 or 2 minute video about the three most important things people need to know about the market. Then you can take that video, add an image, add some text, and you're good to go, right? You're pretty simple. It's pretty simple. If I were to hit play, that video would play. And then we've got that kind of graphic right there. Now you could also add some additional images. If you wanted to add additional images, if you had a longer video, you might want to add additional images of, you know, maybe other parts of San Francisco. But I find that this kind of video works really well for market updates. You could also do this type of video. Maybe you're featuring three local businesses. So you've got three pictures of three local businesses. You could go into Canva and upload those pictures. And then you've got a little talking head of yourself talking about what those businesses are. The other nice part about this is you can also resize this. So if I'm in Canva, I can hit resize and I can resize this to a vertical video, like a reel. Now the resize function is only available if you have Canva Pro. So if you have a free account, you can't resize it, but you could still create a vertical video. This is just a nice feature if you do have a Pro account, that way you're not kind of reinventing the wheel. So if I click Instagram Reel, it's gonna copy and resize it. And now it's gonna take that market update video that was horizontal that's gonna work well for YouTube or Facebook. And now it's gonna turn it into something I could use for TikTok or for Instagram Reels or anything like that, YouTube Shorts. So again, I kind of wanna rearrange it a little bit. You can see my video part is really small. So I would make this bigger. I probably would make this a little bit bigger like that. Maybe kind of play around with the font size a little bit, make it look accurate. But now we've got two great videos, right? You've got one, and obviously the video would be longer than 9 seconds. This is probably something you would record for a minute or two, but now you've got something that's horizontal that you can put on YouTube or Facebook or LinkedIn if you'd like. And now you can also take that and make that shorter. And yeah, you've got something you can use for your Instagram Reels, Facebook Reels, YouTube Shorts, TikTok, things like that. So that's what I love. I think it's really easy to do. Like I said, I think the two big takeaways are use the templates, as we talked about, from Canva. Check those out. That's a really easy way to create content, even if you haven't even created video, because there's some really great templates. And then number two, if you're creating some video from scratch, you can either upload video from your computer or your phone, or just record in Canva, right? Just record in Canva. Again, you can record that small size, or you can make that larger. And if I go back to this original video, I'm going to share one last thing before we wrap up the video here. If you didn't want a small picture of yourself, maybe you wanted yourself to be full screen, I am just going to click on this picture. I'm going to delete the picture, and I'm going to actually delete my video and delete that little image. I'm going to go back to videos, and I'm just going to, you'll see my whole video library is right here. I'm going to click on that video, and now it is full size. So if I didn't want, that image behind me, if I didn't want to be a small circle, if I wanted to be kind of full screen, I could do that. And then of course I could move the text around, which is great. I can add, change the colors. I can change the effects. Yeah. Things like that, outline it, whatever I'd like to do to kind of enhance that as well. Now, by the way, we have a whole video on video editing, because that's a whole other conversation. So we will make sure to link that below, but check that out if you really want to take your Canva video to the next level. Okay. What'd you think? Let me know. I can't wait to see what you create inside of Canva.
There we go. Those are some of my favorite tips when it comes to Canva for video. I would love to hear from you. Which tip was your favorite? Let me know in the comments below. And if you enjoyed this video, like we said earlier, we would love if you'd hit the subscribe button and the bell button, as we have new videos that come out each and every week. And last but not least, if you're thinking, I got to get a handle on my Canva, we would love for you to download our free Canva checklist. Go to katielance.com/Canva and get it downloaded. Thanks so much. We'll see you soon, and I'll see you on Canva.